Hello students, I hope you all are healthy and good. I am Arshia Sayed from Rajiv Gandhi English Primary and High School, running under Paschim Maharashtra Education Trust. Students, before proceeding for further, okay, we are just taking a quick example or quick recap of the same chapter, Natural Resources. In the last video, we had discussed natural resources, definitions, what are the natural resources, air, water, land, soil. These all are the natural resources. So in the last video, we had discussed with lots of examples, a man doing so many activities, okay, in agriculture, in farms, in lands, okay. The next thing is the fishing, okay. Fishing, how fishing is acquired, how fishing is occur, is that. So wood mining. So these all are the resources which is related to nature, okay. So in that, we had discussed soil, water, animal. With the help of this soil, water, animal, these all are the natural resources. Okay, man act with the help of these natural resources. So we will continue the same chapter. In same chapter, we are discussing the last topic. Take out book and take out page number 49. So students, this is the last topic in the same chapter. Depending on the characteristics like physiography, soil, climate, minerals, and availability of water in different regions of the world, land is used for various purposes. Okay, out of this, soil, water, animal, okay, these all are present in land. Where it is present? It is present in land. So land is the main and important resource. Whatever activities we are doing, they all are performing on land. So land is the biggest resources. The proportion of land on earth is occupied 29.20%. How much is occupied? It is occupied about 29.20% land is made up of. Depending on the characteristics of land and climate, various living things are found on the land in different proportion. Okay, due to climatic conditions, due to temperature changes, these lands or the living things which are present on the lands, they have a different proportions. Okay, the distribution of these living organism, including humans, is not uniform. Obviously, humans hai, animals hai, the distribution is not uniform. Somewhere population is very high, but the animals is less. Somewhere animal is high, population is less. So there is no uniformity in that. Okay, proportion means the proportion, it is changeable. Some, it is flexible. Okay, it is flexed from up to down. All living things try to adapt to the various geographical conditions, like a rocky terrace, steep slopes, flat plains, mountainous regions, forest covered areas, rivers and basins, etc. Okay, whatever living things which are present on the land, they are adapted to the geographical condition. Geographical condition means what? The temperature, the climate, the humidity, whatever things which are present on the or in the nature, that means it is known as the geographical condition. So geographical condition like rocky terrace, slow flats, mountain regions, forest covered areas, river bends. Man alone attempts to make changes in the prevailing conditions to suit his needs. Okay, out of these, okay, animals, animal obviously they are changing from the surrounding, but man, it's a one of thing, one of the living being which are depend totally on the nature, or as well as they are depend upon own self, because they are changing their to surrounding condition, changing itself due to the surrounding condition, changing itself due to their our needs, okay, basic needs. Every living things makes use of natural resources. Obviously, whatever natural resources are present, or in that living things are also present. So living things, they are uses natural resources. Okay, water hai, animals hai, waters hai, air hai, they are using for their own purposes. So resources according to its needs. However, man started using many of these resources for himself. It's out of these, man are only started their own resources for their needs. Himself alone with the help of its intellectual power. How it is started the resources by its own help, self, by this of intellectual power. Okay. Later, the increase in population and the greed of humans led to exploitative use of resources. Why they are using their brains? Because of the high population, because of the high demanding populations. So due to the high population, they are exploiting use of resources. This begins to upset the balance in nature. Obviously, population is increasing day by day. We are doing lots of activities. So that's why the natural resources get disturbed. Natural resources get wasted. Okay, they get bulk due to lots of human activities, lots of different purposes. They are using different activities. So, for example, water. Water gets polluted due to the industrial waste, sewage waste, whatever waste is there. There we all are throwing in the dams, rivers, floods. Okay, so that's why the natural resources get danger and not water, natural resources they get bad. This means that is necessary that the man also must use the natural resources only according to his needs and in a judicious manner. Okay, so if we are living in the nature, okay, it's our responsibility to save environment. So it's our responsibility to save our environment, our surroundings, okay, clean and clear, hygienic, maintain hygienic conditions, okay, clear the water wells and surrounding areas, okay, we do not use overuses, okay, we use only what's our needs. So these all are the natural resources, soil, water, animal, land, minerals, these all are the natural resources. So if we are a human being or if we are a good human being, so use natural resources to our daily or requirement, whatever we need, we took only that much only and that much quantity. It's our responsibility. So I have you understood this chapter, natural resources. Natural resources, in that we have discussed soil, water, animal, different resources which are using in day-to-day life. So use it, but with safe. Okay, I hope you all are understood. Thank you so much. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.